Hugo Film Festival year 2017. This is our seventh year. And this year we're very fortunate to have these master classes that are being offered here at the Digital Nest. What I'd like to introduce to you, Matt Pierce. And Matt Pierce is an animator and a filmmaker. He's Monterey based. And he's a CSUMB graduate from the Cinematic Arts Program. He likes offbeat humor. He has produced many short films, and presently he's a teacher, just started recently, at the Digital Arts and at the Millennium Charter High School in Salinas, right? And he teaches digital arts and animation. So, welcome.
I was going to say that all myself, but
doing my job for me, that's fine.
So, I figured I'd put together a little thing talking about animation. A little bit about myself. I teach over at Millennium Charter High. I make a lot of short films. I'll just show you guys a couple of things I made. Let's see if sound works. Give it a load. I really should have. I think I have this one downloaded. Pushed that a little more, but that one was entirely made with After Effects. I made it in about a couple months. It's all motion graphics. Here's something I made like a million years ago. This next slide. No. There we go. This one I made entirely in Flash.
This town is bad, 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 bad. I'm a detective. I detect the bad, 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 bad. Tell me the story, officer policeman.
Oh, officer detective, I tell you, a bad man did a bad thing when no one was looking.
Was it whopping?
No.
A bad cuss?
No.
Was it modal?
Yes.
I make dumb cartoons. Alright, I hope you guys weren't expecting anything impressive, but let's talk about butts. Alright, so there's a lot of situations where you want to animate and you'll be like, I want to animate something, but, and how many of you guys actually already animate stuff? Alright, so you're going to be familiar with these because you've already overcome them, but the rest of you guys are just kind of interested in it, right? But you've got all these things in the way, right? So I'm gonna cover the most common one that I run into all the time with my classes, where my first big but is, I want to animate, but I can't draw. How many of you guys have felt this way before, or you said this to yourself? All right, so here's my solution for this. I want you guys to grab that part of your brain, all right? That part of your brain that says, I can't draw. Just sit it down. You'll lean in real close. If you look it in the eye, I want you to tell it, shut up. Alright? Because the only solution to this, well, actually, here's some cartoon wisdom.
Yes.
I win.
Oh, what? That was a good move.
Thanks.
Dogcopter, how do you do it?
How do I do what?
I mean, what's your secret? How'd you get so talented?
Don't focus so much on talent, Steven. Making art is all about communication. A piece of art is a conversation. Every choice you make is a statement. Don't worry about labels or conforming to a standard. Just be true to yourself, and people will appreciate your honesty.
Whoa. Thanks for the advice.
And take a deep breath.
What?
Really, I'm kind of a firm believer in what Dogcopter said there about, like, art's really about communication. It's not necessarily about being really good at drawing, even though that sometimes helps. It's not the most important thing. The most important thing is getting an idea across, telling a story, that kind of thing. So my solution is just draw anyway. Who cares if you can't draw? And I've got a case study here. So this is probably the best comic book ever made. It's called One Punch Man. The artist for the comic that you guys... How many of you guys have heard of this one here? Yeah. All right, so the comic you guys are probably familiar with was illustrated by Yusuke Murata, but it was written by a guy who just calls himself One. That's the only name he's ever given. And this is his original comic. This is what it was all based off of. This guy is not the best artist. But he's a fabulous writer, and he's actually got a really good sense of, like, composition and layouts and timing in a comic. And so he just made the comic himself with his own art. There's everything that, if you've ever read the manga of One Punch Man, this one, everything that happens in that happens in this, in his original webcomic. And he just teamed up with his friend and made a more professional version of it. But if you just persevere and draw with what you got, what you can do, the things that you are good at will usually shine through, I hope. I hope that's advice. I don't know. Here's the second big but. I don't have the tools. So has anybody run into this but? Alright, so I'm going to give you guys some solutions right now. So in an ideal world, everyone would have a free copy of Adobe Creative Suite. That's what I use for everything. If you're like a student at CSUMB, you can actually get it for free. A lot of times there will be like student discounts, so high school students. At my school, we've got a license deal where we've got it on the computers over there. But it does cost money. It's pretty expensive. And I use all of these ones all the time for like all my stuff. But there's also free alternatives. Feel free to write these down. I think there's little notepads around there. But these ones I discovered pretty recently. Fire Alpaca is a really decent free drawing app, and it's got onion skin functions to it. I'm pretty sure it works for both Mac and Windows. All these should work for both Mac and Windows. So Fire Alpaca is a pretty powerful free app. It's pretty handy. I found that one recently. It's cute. Magic of Voxel lets you do 3D stuff, but in like voxel style. So if you've ever seen like Minecraft or something where they make like a giant structure out of blocks. That's kind of what Magic of Voxel does, but it actually has animation function in it, that's pretty cool. And Pencil 2D, I wouldn't recommend doing a full project with it, but it's great for practice, and as long as you're practicing, you can do all sorts of stuff. So as far as tablets go, a lot of times people are like, I wish I had a drawing tablet, but they're so expensive. This one, I actually brought one of these with me, wherever my bag is. I highly recommend this one. I just got it a couple months ago.
Where is it? There it is.
It's super lightweight. It's a perfect like portable tablet. It works on both Mac and PC. It's only $25 on Amazon.
This is a really good deal.
And this doesn't need a battery. So some comparable ones, they need a battery. This is a really great deal. The XP Pen G430. If you just search cheap tablets on Amazon, you can get those. There's also a bunch of free apps for mobile devices, so your iPad, smartphone. One that I highly recommend you guys get is Stop Motion Studio. It's for stop motion stuff, so like claymation, Wallace and Gromit, Coraline, that kind of thing. But it's great to practice with, and any animation you do is going to apply to other animation you do. So I highly recommend Stop Motion Studio. It's free. It's for everything. This one, Framecast, I just discovered recently, and I started playing around with it. It's really powerful. I think it's only for iOS devices, though. But here's something dumb I made in Framecast a couple days ago.
Cheers! Cheers, love.
It's a little video game thing. But, yeah, you can actually do, like, sound in it. The audio quality's not great, but, I mean, you can make, like, full little animated short things in Framecast.
It's great.
And then, also, if you have a 3DS, how many of you guys have a 3DS? One of you. If you ever find yourself with a 3DS little game console, there's a program called Flipnote Studio. I highly recommend you get it. This guy is named KK, the guy who made all these. K-E-K-E. He makes tons of animations, and he's, like, world famous now. He's a French animator. And most of his stuff he just does in Flipnote 3D, which is just on his little video game console. So Flipnote 3D Studio is great. And barring all that, just make a flip book. Look at this guy. There's more.
Oh.
So this guy's got like, I'm pretty sure this guy's got like a bajillion views. He just makes flipbooks, and all you really need is a bunch of like index cards and a clamp and a pencil, and you can just start practicing on your own like that. Third big butt is I don't have time. I gotta work on my segues. I didn't practice this ahead of time at all. So third big butt is I don't have time, and this is a really big issue for me personally. This is the one that I'm always complaining about. What time is it now? Oh, we got a lot of time. So, my solution for that is, heck, let's just animate something right now. Everybody open up your laptop. Jump on, there's a website called piskelapp.com. Save all your work to it automatically. So I recommend signing in. I've got my own sign in right here. And then if you don't want to sign in, that's fine too. So once you're signed in, go ahead and click Create Sprite. I'll just walk you guys through the process of this. I'll use a trackpad too, so we're all in even footing. So I think I'm going to make this a little bigger. I'm going to make my canvas bigger. Over here on the right hand side, it's full screen. Over here on the right-hand side, there's a little resize icon here. Also, let me know if I'm going too fast. I tend to do that. And then my kids are like, Mr. Pierce, I don't know how you got there. All right, so if you click resize, I'm going to just do 60 by 60. It's a good space to look in. So So what this app does is it's free, it's browser-based, you can work on it from anywhere, and you can make pixel art animations really easy. Pixel art's a whole discipline, but it's also not very intimidating for beginners. So I'm gonna pick a color over here on the left, maybe a green. I'm just gonna draw a blob. Here's a cute blob. I'm not gonna fill it in yet, because it's easier to animate if you just have outlines. And I'm gonna go over here to add new frame. Where'd my blob go? So, over here on the right side, there's a little thing called onion skin. Can you guys all see that, onion skin? Any good animation app is gonna have an onion skin function where you click on that, you can see a ghost of your previous frame. So I clicked on onion skin and I can see my previous drawing. Now I'm going to draw another one. I draw a little bit lower. And you can see up here in the corner there's a little preview of it. I'm going to full screen that. I'm going to make another frame. I'm going to draw that one a little bit lower. Is anybody behind? Does anybody need help? Usually what I'll do when I'm teaching you. Usually what I'll do when I'm teaching classes, I'll just walk around and be like, okay, you're definitely done. Let's see where you're at.
Okay, click on onion skins. And then go ahead and add a new frame. And see, there's a ghost of your previous frame.
Oh, okay.
One thing I did not put on the presentation that I would like you guys to look up if you're interested in getting better at animation once you get the tools all squared away. And that is called the 12 Principles of Animation. I would write that down and look it up on YouTube later. There's a... Here we go. There's a playlist, this one right here. This one's really good. They explain everything just right off
the bat. Hey guys, so I just...
I'm not going to let this guy do my presentation for me, but I recommend you guys check this out later. They talk about stretch and squash, anticipation, basically everything you need to make a really... make your animations really pop. On some programs, you can choose how many frames you see with the onion skin, but on this one, I think it only does the one before and after.
Oh, okay.
So, for instance, if I were to make a frame in between these two, drag that there, see, I can see the one before and after. I don't think you can adjust that in this frame. You can see in the corner there, I've got a little jumping thing going on. Yeah, I can see even bigger, maybe not. I don't know. Sometimes preview works, sometimes it doesn't. That I have all my students do right off the bat is just make bean boys, where you just make a little blob and then you add legs and add like a face to it. Because it's really kind of a low commitment animated character.
can also copy things. I don't recommend zooming in with the keypad. It's a bad idea. I shouldn't have done that. Here we go. Zoom in with. So, on a laptop, there's different ways to zoom in. I don't think you guys can even do it. Never mind. I think on the MacBook you can. If you zoom in like that, don't do that. You can zoom in up and down with two fingers. That works. Thing I like to do is I like to have the face moving a little bit slower than the body. You can see when the body's going down, the face is like at the top of the head. This is another important part of animation, is just quietly hammering away at it. If you look closely at the different tools on the side here, there's mirror tool, there's paint bucket. They've got all the really basic ones that you'd need for pixel art. Some programs have extra stuff like, I don't know, like blending tools, that kind of thing. I can actually show you guys. So it should actually be playing up in the top right corner. You can zoom in if you want. If you want to export what you've done, though, there's a little thing on the right. So if you're signed in, you can actually save your work to your gallery, and you can go back and edit it later.
Okay.
But right below the save icon is a thing called export. You get all these export settings. You can actually even change the scale. So if you just make it the regular scale, it's going to be really tiny because it's only a few pixels. pixels wide, but you can actually scale it up. It's like 800 is pretty good if you want to like put it in a video or something. You can download it as PNG sequences or posting online, that kind of thing. Shoot, I really should have brought my iPad.
Parts.
Yeah.
So what I would recommend is just you could trace over those.
Okay.
Or you could do this. Grab it. See? This should work. Command B, paste.
Oh, okay.
So you can copy paste the different pieces. And then all that, grab that. Command C. And then over here, go ahead.
Cool, okay. Thank you. It's working.
Yeah, that's something I have to learn how to more effectively teach is drawing the same drawing over again to make sure the animation continues.
Yeah.
Let's do this for maybe another 5 minutes, and then I'll show you guys the stop motion app, Stop Motion Studio.
Can we? Is it in the top corner? We can see it animate.
Yeah.
Will it always be that fast?
Right below the preview image, there's a little thing called FPS.
Uh-huh.
That's your frames per second. So you can actually lower that if you want to,
or
speed it up if you want it really crazy. Look at that. Actually, that's about it. Now I'm happy with his movement. I'm going to go ahead and fill him in. So I'm going to grab my eyedropper tool and color. So if you have a smartphone and you're interested in doing stop motion, you can go ahead and start downloading that now. Or like a tablet device or anything. So I'm going to show you guys how it makes sense. I should have brought my iPad. I'm sorry. I was like, I don't need it. I should have brought it. I could have shown you guys a million things on that. My phone will work. save it to your personal gallery, and then you can also export it as a gift from like. You can do that. So right underneath the save icon, right there, there's a little. It looks like a picture of a mountain with a sun.
Oh, okay.
And if you click on that, you can actually export it as like a gift. And from there, you can post it on like Facebook or Tumblr or any other kind of website. Anybody want to share their stuff? We'll just plug you in.
Is there HDMI on this one?
No, there's not.
There should be like some stuff right there. Over there, the little bucket thing.
Oh! Adapter. It's okay. We'll just lift it up really high. What's your name?
Myra.
So here's a cute little animation Myra made. A flower growing. So cute.
Thanks.
One thing you could probably do to improve it too is like you could have it so like there's a bud and have the bud grow.
Yeah.
And like
oh yeah.
But that's great. That's good
for
a person. You colored it. So what you would do to make a move is,
oh, and then
every frame, turn on the onion skin, and then you can see the previous drawing. So now you draw one that's kind of similar to it, and have the arms like moving slightly.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It's always those little things. So this isn't intimidating though, right? Like this is a really good little jumping off point, I think.
You guys are just doing complicated designs. I get it.
Do you guys want to keep working on this, or should I show you guys one more thing? You guys all sign in? Because you can always save your work and work on it later. I'll wait till 5:40 and then in like the last 10 minutes I'll show you one thing. Wait. This will be cool. I think you guys will like this. Different ways for each principle of animation.
Yeah,
oh, dang. This happens to me all the time at work. Kids will be like, Mr. Perry. Turn around. I've been presenting for like 5 minutes. So I made voice for like each principle of animation. So this one's scratch and squash. I think this one's anticipation. So he squats down before he screams. This one's layout. So there's two different ways. Once you're comfortable enough with the program, there's two different ways you can animate something. You can either do pose to pose, where you plan out your poses ahead of time, and then you just come up with the in-betweens, like, afterwards. So, see, I got the three poses there that I wanted, and then I came up with all the stuff in between it. And then the other way is, straight ahead. Straight ahead is where you don't plan it ahead at all, you just animate one frame, and then the next frame, and then the next frame. And so that's what I did with that little hair on his head. And if you blend them, you can actually get some pretty cool results. Straight ahead animation is great for like things you can't really predict, like hair and fire and like water and stuff. And then pose to pose is great for like planned little choreographed movements. Follow through and overlapping action. He's got a little bit of jiggle there when he stops. This one's easing. These are all things that you want to look at once you're more comfortable with the program itself and you've made a few little test animations. Arcs. Always one thing is moving in an arc, opposed to just straight ahead. You guys something real quick. So I've loaded up the Stop Motion Studio app. It's free. It works on most mobile devices. It's really great. And what it lets you do is you can actually make stop motion. So I'm gonna like walk around and show you guys. So like you guys have seen like Wallace and Gromit, Coraline, that kind of thing, right? Claymation. So it's both the hardest and easiest thing to animate. So like, I'm gonna take a picture of this bucket right here. That's my first frame. And then, this actually has its own form of onion skin where you can drag up the transparency and you can see the previous frame right there. So let's see how I can see the previous picture I took. So that lets me line it up. So slightly. I'll try to line it up as best I can. Normally you'd work on a tripod for something like this, but I'm a fool. Here, let's see, I'm gonna do another one. Could you just move it just a tiny bit?
Is that good?
Yeah. Alright, and now move it a tiny bit more. 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 A little bit more. A little bit more. Directing these is a lot more fun than I should do. Alright, let's try that out. Now we go back to look at the animation we made. Look at that. It looks like it's moving around on its own.
That's cool. What is that one called?
That one's called stop motion. It's pretty easy to remember because it's literally what the technique is. But that one's free on both iOS and Android. There is a paid version you can get that gives you some more features, but the free version you can do pretty much everything with it. I was making some little test guy with it right here where he's like stomping around. So if you get some clay, you can do some really like crazy, like, actually, I don't know if I can load it up. Sure.
That's really cool. I'm definitely going to use
that. Yeah, I highly recommend that. And if you blend that with drawn animation, so for instance, if you make a flip book, you could take the pictures in stop motion and animate it that way. I'm good there, man. Yeah, you can actually export them in different formats. So you can export it as a video, and you can even edit it in like a larger video editing software.
Cool.
Yeah, all the stuff that I shared with you guys are things that like I recommend as things that I use myself. For more or less, the alpaca one I played with a little bit, and it seems pretty solid. also, if you start getting pretty decent at animating and you still live in Monterey, you'll be one of the only animators in Monterey, because there aren't that many. Which you'd think would lead to more jobs.
Yeah.
It's kind of like being in an exclusive club.
I think animation is a cool way of like advertising and like getting your name out there.
Oh yeah. When it's done well.
Yeah, when it's done well. Yeah.
But then to do it well, like the dog copter said, it doesn't necessarily have to be drawn well, it just has to be have some semblance of genuineness.
Right.
And a lot of times in like, because there is bad animation, a lot of times in bad animation you'll notice like there's not really any genuineness to it.
Yeah. So you make short films.
Yeah.
How long does that take?
It depends on the project.
Uh-huh.
Some videos, like that Slime Girls one, took me a couple months because I was trying out a lot of new things with it too.
Right.
But something like Bad City, that one took me like maybe a few days. So once you're really comfortable with the program too, you can crank stuff out as long as you know like what you're doing ahead of time. Stop Motion Studio. So I just drew 3 frames. I drew a little guy doing in one pose of doing the monkey. It's like that. And then I drew this blur frame where it looks like his hands are going really fast. And then I drew this pose where his hands are alternated. And now I'm going to use this app and we'll see if it works. And then if I were feeling really crazy, if I like how this motion turns out, first of all. There you go. Oops. It's a very quiet workshop.
Sorry. I'm looking at the Vita projector for a Mac.
Oh yeah, that's more frames. Yes, sir. If I was feeling really crazy, I could cut this out and put him like in front of this.
Yeah.
And it would look like he's dancing in front of it. Which is actually a really cool idea you guys should steal.
I used to draw like little pictures of my friends,
mm-hmm.
like little cartoon versions of them, and then like put them in like spaces where they would be and take photos of them.
That's
but cool. Having this and like having that idea and like
yeah.
doing it in a stop motion.
Also, alternatively, if you were to animate them using like a program like this or something, you could use After Effects and just put them in there too.
Yeah, that's true.
That would actually be easier.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see how that looks. Look at that, he looks like he's dancing really fast.
That's really dope.
Oh. So that's another really easy way to just like do like test animations and stuff too. Make the frames.
So what app is that?
This one is called Stop Motion.
Stop Motion?
Yeah, it's free. It's really good. It's for iOS and Android. So, yeah, it's free.
Can you see it?
Huh?
Can you see it?
So,
you guys see that? I just made that just now.
But, the nice thing is, like, you can use it for all sorts of stuff. You can export them as like QuickTime files.
So you can edit them in larger programs afterwards.
Yeah. And it's called stop action?
Stop motion.
Stop.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah, it's a really good program.
Stop motion, right?
Yeah. And then, that's actually something I want to do as like an official lesson with my kids, is I want to have them make like claymation creatures, and then we're going to put it all together in like a show.
Nice, I like it.
Yeah, I highly recommend that one.
And it's the one that looks like it has like the film.
Yeah, it's got the blue icon to it. Yeah, I'll load up my. Also, if you have an iOS device, there's another one called Framecast, where it's for just drawing. It's not a stop motion app, but it's really powerful. I just found it
for drawing
the other day. Yeah, it's for like doing like drawn animation. So like, I'll play this one again.
And that's Framecast.
Yeah, Framecast. I don't think it's for iOS. It's not for Android yet, but it's for like iOS, so like iPhone.
Cheers.
Let's put sound
cheers,
on.
Cheers, love.
Really powerful program.
But I believe if you establish, you can upload it to something to where you can put sound in.
With stop motion, you can always do it in post. But this one's nice for just like doing like things really quick. But
yeah, awesome.
And it also like lets you export and upload like Instagram and stuff and like directly.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's nice to have. And also, if you have a 3DS, I recommend this one. I'll just go back through these. Actual physical.
Yes.
And these are some like cross-platform free ones for computer, like PC, Mac. They work for both. Pencil 2D is great for like just pencil tests, that kind of thing. Like simple test animations. We got about 8 minutes left. Does anybody have anything they want to share? Yeah? All right, does that have an HDMI port?
Yeah.
You can just plug it in.
Let me see.
It does not. We'll just show it around. That's actually with pixel art, being able to like render something recognizable at like a really small scale is a really valuable skill. There's a whole discipline to it where I think I've got a couple examples on here. Like sometimes there's really good pixel art, sometimes there's people who just do it as like a device. Let me see, I don't have my examples up here. No, I mean, in a way, this is pixel art too, this guy. He does it at a really small scale, you can see the pixels there. I just love that this guy did all this with his own Nintendo device. That's all I got. I hope you guys learned something. Hope you guys like this part. I was really proud of this.
Yeah. I really
like that.